We are in September, so it's time for the August recap. During August, we worked on a few things. Well, let's start from the core experience. So rent is fully rolled out. If you don't know what rent is, the TLDR is that it's a new way the synchronization is architected. And so it means that synchronization is now faster for many, many of the actions that people do on Evernote, like syncing notes between devices and sharing and other things. But we have a full video dedicated to it. We also have a new device limit for free accounts, which we've talked about already. And we introduced AI-powered image to text, which was pretty appreciated. I saw it was nice to see. You can now basically transcribe any image to text that you can later modify, cut, copy and paste, etc. The cool thing is that it works both on screenshots of documents or web pages, but also on handwriting. And I personally was so surprised by how well it works with handwriting, even bad handwriting, even as bad as mine. Then we have a few quality of life improvements as usual now. The first of all is that we now have, thanks to popular requests, table of contents that auto-updates. Now you don't need to manually delete and insert a new one when you update your document. The table of contents is now an interactive block that updates whenever you edit the structure of the document. So if you change titles and headings, it will also be reflected in the table of contents. The pin to notebook feature, where you can take a note and pin it to a notebook so it appears at the top of the list, it's also now accessible from inside the note, which is the place most people were looking for this feature but weren't finding it. So now it's much easier to access. We also have some improved readability on notes on mobile. The thing that was happening is that previously Evernote would update the size of the text throughout the app based on the setting that you select on your operating system accessibility setting, like font size setting in general, but not inside the note editor. So now we worked to make it so that by default, also the editor reflects the settings that you choose to have in the phone setting. Plus, you can also select manually the size that you want to render your note at. So you can choose if you want it to match your phone setting or your actual manual setting inside Evernote settings. You can also now mark notifications as read or unread. So you sometimes, every once in a while, you receive notifications. Previously, you had to actually click on the notification to mark it as read. Now you can just click on the little button to stop it from being from appearing in the red dot. Basically, now you only see a CAPTCHA when it's actually needed. Plus, security is much improved. We tweeted about it. It's actually not something that a lot of people know. I encourage you to go read the tweet. It's pretty dense in information. We've also fixed a bunch of bugs. So let me go through a quick list of the main ones. So the first one was pretty annoying. If you exceeded the size for an audio recording, your recording was lost. Of course, maybe you didn't know about the limit, you didn't think about it, etc. So you might lose your audio in case you exceeded the limit. Now that's not going to happen anymore. You now have automatic notebook filtering in search. So if you're inside a notebook and you click the search bar, it will by default search inside that notebook. And many, many more bug fixes like anchor links, filtering in notebooks and searching within notes, etc., 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 etc. To be updated on the latest bug fixes, I encourage you to look at the tracker that we put online. Try to keep it as up-to-date as possible, so you have a list of everything we track as something that we know of, with some information about when we first discovered the problem and when we are planning. Basically, we will update it when we fix it so that you know that it's been fixed in version XYZ. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. See you next month.